Got it here, $500 junk door box over here. Pretty nice and heavy. Let's see what's inside. Okay, let's open it up. Boom, oh my gosh, so much stuff. Love it. Okay, well packaged. Looks like it's in the little Ziploc bags like that. So yeah, looks like in a way it's like multiple junk doors. I think that's what I did. Bought a whole bunch of junk doors that is under $100, sometimes under $50. And they packaged it all in one box. I guess I could title it $10-$50 junk doors or just one $500 junk door. So let's see what we got here. Some vintage stuff. Don't see store on it, so generic stuff. Let's look at the coins real quick. Is there any silver? Okay, 1968, 40% silver, Indian head penny, 1880. There you go, there's a $20 smelt value piece dollar, 90% silver. Very common date, 1922. 1960, Washington quarter, 90% silver, nice. Steel penny, looks like a pretty good quality, but I seen way better. I think I even have way better. 1929 Buffalo nickel, that's not silver, and there's a quarter. They're just okay coins over here. Gonna put them in here, and a bunch of copper. Let's keep going. We got here a watch, Fossil. Fossil is supposed to be pretty good watches. Is it working? Don't really know how expensive that is and if it's working. Gonna put it in my watch pile. Looks like a little like soap dish, some kind of bowling pin, and a few more like collectible vintage things. So vintage matches, beautiful, people collect those. More vintage matches, whiteheads, I like it. Couple of pearl earrings and spoons, Oklahoma. Another pin, what is that, kitchen holder of some sort. Oh, I don't know if you guys will, this is pretty interesting, some kind of bowling piece over here too. And a toy car, 1 out of 100, but quality is horrible. Okay, let's keep going, let's see what else we're gonna have. This is a pretty nice miniature junk drawers of random stuff. Look, we're getting a whole collection of matches. This one's dark and white. More matches over here. You could sell them probably as a pile together. Somebody collects those kind of stuff. Okay, some kind of letter opener. It's actually pretty sharp. Oh, nice. Okay, what else we have here? This is gold 14 card heavy gold electric plate. So EP plated. So that's cool. I mean, I don't know, probably can sell it for like $5 or something, who knows. Just generic jewelry in a way, plated is not that good. But we can test it, see if it's actually plated over silver. Okay, I can hear the gas come out, vintage lighters, I like it, but the clicker is out. So that's pretty much junk. Ooh, I see something really good. I don't see the CC, Morgan Silver dollar. Oh my gosh, inside of a junk door with that with that quality. Let's look at it at the phone. Oh my gosh. I don't see lots of hairlines, so it's probably not cleaned. And this is 1921. That's the only problem with this coin, is that's not rare. It's pretty common date, so might be not worth sending it off for grading, but I might. It looks like a pretty good looking coin. Might send off for grading, see what we'll get. Maybe 65 64, that's a hope, but it's probably will come back 64, and we don't want to get grade cleaned or graffiti. So that's a really good score in this junk door. Really nice, good looking coin. Standing Liberty, 90% silver, quarter. What date? 1926? I think you shoot for 1917 key dates and stuff. 1939 quarter. I don't know about key dates or like career dates for the quarters, but it's a nice quarter set here. Maltvalo for sure. Bishop Daniel, I think. This one, okay. 1940. Is this silver? I don't remember the years of 5 cents, but it's only like 40% silver, so not very much money anyways. 1926, and more steel pennies and copper. Gold going to just circle a coin pile. Okay, more. Looks like this is a product of Japan. They say $300. That's funny. Sometimes these jewelry and junk doors are so overpriced. Paddock of Japan pearls. Pretty cool. Don't know much about pearls. How much do they worth? Another Japanese little box over here. Toenail clipper. That's kind of cute. And like a cast iron, a toy soldier. That's pretty unique. Some would maybe collectible. I don't know. But this thing is pretty awesome, hefty. Okay, let's keep going. I see a fire truck over here. And some kind of glasses holder. Okay, I actually have a couple already. And this thing bends so easily. I don't know what it's made from. But as you can see, it's all bent up. I feel like it's made from like one of those metals that is not good for you. Like lead or something, yeah. So I probably would put it in the garage. I actually have two other ones from a junk door, building up a whole collection of them. Just worried if it's made from lead or not. Let me know in comments below, because this stuff is so easily bended, it's pretty concerning. Okay, what is this? Ray-Bans or some? This is stayed up a junk door whenever you get glasses like that. That's weird. That's for sure junk. Unless it's gold, I don't know. More jewelry, pearls. A whole collection of pearls. Okay, I see a watch. Something very unique. More buffalo nickel. 90%. Nope. This is another 50 cents. Ooh, look at that one. Good quality, but 90% silver this time. Some junk silver, Indian head penny, 1903, nice, 54, and another piece dollar, 1922, junk silver and copper. More matches, this one's used up, not new, not as good. Generic jewelry, more matches, oh nice, this one's new. Some vintage keys, bent. Okay, knife, Florida. Okay, we got here a watch. Let's see what's in here. Oh wow, this one is beat up. Okay, let's keep going. Let's see what we got in here. This is a pretty nice junk doors for sure. Okay, so generic jewelry. Another glasses. No, this ones are not broken. This is weird. Is this like gold plated or something? What's so special about them? They're definitely huge and vintage. I wonder what's the market for them. Oh wow, check this out. This one like a safety glasses. It says Taiwan on them. That's a pretty interesting. Belt buckle. I see people sell belt buckles like crazy on eBay. Okay, vintage lighters. Let's see if they strike. Don't strike, needs to be refurbished. But it's Coca-Cola and another Coca-Cola. This one has a flint, so that's nice. And this is actually lighter fluid. Interesting, not the best quality. Wow, look at this paper matches. That's huge. Interesting, I like it. So yeah, that's pretty cool. And it says New York. That's definitely better paper matches. Yeah, I'm gonna have a whole collection of paper matches. Check this out. These keys. Keys are definitely junk. Okay, there is something even better with these coins. Let's dump them out. I see the Bubble Dime. Wow, this is definitely old, 1893. I don't see the date. Okay, 50 cents. A bunch of junk. Okay, that's kind of cool. 1987, good quality. That's at least $35 with premium silver eagle. 999 silver. That's good. 1964, 90% silver. Vinnicle 1911. Don't remember the value key dates. So that's cool. We look into it and more copper. And couple more like really bad quality toys over here. Let's keep going. This is gonna be a long video. We have so many junk doors over here. That's a really good value junk doors. Never know, sometimes you buy stuff and you're like, okay. It's like almost like a mystery box. Don't know nothing about this thing. We'll have to look into it later. So there's more unique like metal stuff. What is this? Oh, this is like one of those, I would say, weird folders. You'd have to open it kind of like with a nail or something. This is pretty interesting. This is like pretty good quality. I'd say like $5 knife. That's funny. Okay, more flippers, more pearls. Wow, keys. Wow, check out this paper matches. I've never seen paper matches like that. So, very compact. Okay, this thing right here in good quality is money. Like $20-$30 lighters. So that's not bad. Generic jewelry. Wow, check this out. That's kind of useful for something. Definitely putting it in the office, never know. Okay, more generic jewelry. Okay. What is that? Ooh. Nice set of pens. Don't see the branding of it, but this is nice set of pens. Some of those pens are pretty valuable. Still gotta learn about pens a lot. More matchboxes. Okay, I see some graded coins in here. Is it graded? Let's see what grade it is. Ah, I don't like that. This is just whatever. We'll have to grade it again, if anything. What it says, 35% silver. 1943, that's cool. We'll take silver all day. Mercury dime, 1941. Ooh, I love this one. Walking Liberty, 90% silver, 1943. Pretty much it's a generic date, so the smelt value most likely. 37, Buffalo nickel, steel penny. $1, probably we'll sell it as $1. Go spend it or exchange it. Indian head penny. 1905, it says $1.60. That's cool. What is this? Wood penny, Michigan. Interesting. And more copper. I'm getting drowned with the junk doors over here. Check this out. We have to all separate it at once. Let's look two coins real quick, first of all. I like this mini junk doors. Look at that. Steel penny, V nickel. 90% silver, Roosevelt, Walking Liberty, Mercury dime, silver, 1903, that's nice, 85, 50 cents, 946, 5 cents, wow, what is that? That's pretty unique. We'll have to do a little bit of research, and more copper. So coins weren't as good this time, nice matches though. And you got your generic jewelry keys, vintage keys, whole collection. Nice, nice, I like that. We have Formula One thing or whatever. John Deere belt buckle and vintage can opener. More vintage matches. 1930, wow, there's some old matches. And a couple of watches out here. Fossil. Don't know if Fossil is valuable or not, but put on watch pile. Okay, what is this? Ooh, this is like at least $90 over here, maybe 50, depends. This is a little set for like tool set, knife set, This is nice. Let me show it to you real quick. You want to pull in a hammer, just slide it in like this. You have a screwdriver. Oh wow, this is definitely a different one and good quality handle too. So you lift this up, then you put it in and then lock it in. I actually never seen one like that. So you have a miniature hammer and usually they just lock in. This one has a screwdriver locking mechanism. If I could open it back up. Wow, this sits in there really well. Use this ugly spoon to open it back up. Boom. Nice. I don't have a set like that. I have a similar set. And this in itself right here, like $50 to $100 depends. They sell pretty good. Sometimes even more expensive. Again, it all depends on the quality of the tool or whatever else that you're buying or collecting. I'll take that all day in junk drawer. Vintage tools. Okay, let's look to coin sale quick. Okay, this is, what is it? Franklin, half dollar, 59, 5 cents. Silver, 90% silver, steel penny, 1904. It says $1.60, I'll take it. A whole collection over here. Walking Liberty, 35. This is different dates, I like it. Steel penny, okay. Metal, copper. 1971, $1. Some of them silver, I don't know the years of the silver, but yeah, I'll take it. It's a dollar. Can go exchange it at the bank. Okay, generic jewelry. Union Place Railroad, so one of those stirrers, I think, for the coffee. What is that? Le Mirror. More matches. 1982, somebody wrote down and it ruined it. Okay, let's keep going. My butter is about to die, so we're gonna have to reset. Wow, look at that. This is like some kind of receipt holder. Nice. What is that? I have no idea. Whatever. Matches. Nice. A whole collection of matches. I guess it's cool. I'll have a collection of matches. More generic jewelry bracelet. Okay, let's keep going. Another pin. Oh, check out this knife. Ah, it's kind of cheap actually. Belt buckles. Yeah, and look, it's broken. What brand is this? Oh, this is like pretty cheap, $7 knife. And it's broken, so junk. What is this? 14 karat gold. If anything, probably gold plated. Okay, let's keep going. We have another pile of coins. Steel penny. Ooh, this one is a nice quality. 1964 common date, so probably not even worth grading. Morgan silver dollar, another really, really good one. Probably uncirculated. Has a little bit scratches. It says $40. I probably agree with that, but 1900, this is nice. Nice coin. Maybe worth sending it off, get a grade. Vinicle, 1909. So whole bunch of them. Buffalo, 1928. 25 cents. Barber dime, 1906. Really bad condition, so probably silver. But yeah, more keys and copper. Okay, whoa, gold bucks, a whole pile of them. Oh my gosh. And I'll tell you all about the gold bucks over here. Gold bucks is actually Utah, Nevada gold buck. It's like a gold money that is not plated. Look at that. This is one thousand spendable gold. If you have 1 ounce of gold, that's like $2,000. And how do you buy bread with that? So many people are hating on gold. Well, there you go. This is a spendable gold. And as you can see, you can touch it. The gold is actually sealed inside of it. Very, very, very durable money over here. That is actually spendable gold. If a spot of a gold go up, this money value will go up as well. So as efforts go down too. But it's also pretty collectible. People love this a lot. So there you go, gold bucks. two of them, paper matches, but no matches in here, so not as valuable anymore. Baseball cards. What year is this? This is nice. Let's see. 71. Not that old. Not old enough. Some of these stamps are really, really expensive, and there's 1 cent, 2 cents, 3 cents. So yeah, I'll keep this very, very nice and safe. Okay, let's keep going. Hopefully we'll get something really, really old stuff. More gold box over here. A pin. NFL cards. Wow, look at that. 13 cents. Is that a stamp or just dirty? Depends on the quality, there will be a value too. 80s. Ooh, this is looks like an old baseball card. More very nice stamps. Nice. This is 1951 to 1958 over here. This is what we're looking for. A little bit older stuff, but the quality is pretty bad. It's folded. So again, it's all about quality. More gold bucks. I'll take it all day. This is beautiful. This is just one gold bug. The $50 gold bug costs like $170. More vintage pictures over here. Again, two more gold bucks. So if you get 1,000 of these gold bucks, this will make you an 1 troy ounce of gold, which will be worth a couple of thousand in this type of quality of gold, because it's printed. It cost way more to produce than one coin. So yeah, there's like other cards, baseball cards, interesting stuff. And look how big this pile is. Wow, more vintage cards over here. Look at that, more gold bucks. Wow, we got so many gold bucks. This is a nice junk drawers. And there was for sale like about 100 junk drawers out there. And I only bid on 10 of them that I thought I got a good deal on. This is 60s to 71. That's nice. So some of them are really, really nice. Quality 287. Wow, more gold bucks. I think each one is like $5 by itself. 3 cents. This is just a dollar. Such a bad quality. It's probably is still a dollar. So yeah, paper money. Go put it in a different pile. More vintage stamps. This is, whoa, half a cent. I think that's what it says. Nice. Some unique stuff over here. This is more stamp envelope type of stuff. Okay, let's keep going. Oh wow, there's another pile of stamps. We'll look into it. I'll just probably put in a pile whenever I want to look into it. One day I will, but for now, just pile it up. Pile it up. Some vintage stuff over here. Vintage pictures, envelopes, more gold bucks. I'll take that and stamps. Almost like a mystery box over here, because I even forgot. So yeah, that's beautiful. This thing right here, like I think gold plated or somewhat stamp. This thing's from $5 to like $12, some more expensive. Okay, let's see what else we got here. I think this is a really nice junk drawers. This is a wholesale stuff. Look, more gold bucks. Check this out. This is nice stamp over here. Olympic, 20 cents. Two more gold bucks. I wonder how many gold bucks we're gonna get in here. More stamps. $4 for this baseball card. This is nice. 60s from 62. This is nice. Nice stuff. What is this? A coin set? Nope. This is actually a set for whatever you call it. Cards, things that you send off. Okay, more baseball cards. $2. I like it that it's priced, so some older stuff. And another stamp. Beautiful. Okay, let's look through this pile real quick. Another stamp over here. I better keep those together. More gold bucks. Nice. Vintage pictures, baseball cards, beautiful. Pile it up. More stamps. I have a collection of a little bit of everything. Football card, What year is this? 79. This is part of the stamps. Have to find them and put them together. Okay, more gold bucks. Wow, this is amazing junk drawer. You just never know what you're gonna find. Look at that, all these Ziploc bags. How can I use them? So NBA baseball cards. Wow, check this out. Such a good quality of stamps. More gold bucks, two more. $1 for this one, it says. I'll take it. Maybe sell it as a pile one day on eBay. I don't think it's very valuable, but still, it's pretty cool. More baseball cards. Wow, look at that. What year is this? 55 to 60. That's what you want to look for, even older. The older it is, the better. It's a clear history of it for the collectors. So yeah, two more gold bucks. What is this? NFC. What year is that? 79. Wow, that was a nice haul of gold bucks and baseball cards and all type of stuff. Okay, let's keep it going. Really nice packaging over here. Wow, Nordstrom, haha. This is very interesting. Irene, would you wear something like that? I mean, Nordstrom is pretty nice. I wonder if it's just generic or just, don't know how much it costs, but it's pretty interesting. Probably generic jewelry. What is this? Oh, a bunch of more generic jewelry stuff. Another watch over here. Pandora. More vintage matches and a screwdriver. Unique shape. Gosh, I'm like really am drowning and running out of space over here on this table. There's some copper. 936. Buffalo steel penny. 1965 cents. 25 cents. 1903. This one is circulated heavily and toned. Melt value, it's also damaged. 1960 quarter over here. Cool. Don't remember the key dates for that. 1928 Standing Liberty. Pretty good quality. 25 cents. It's silver. I'll take silver all day in the junk drawer. Cool. Okay, what we got here? More vintage matches and pearls and keys. Generic jewelry. More generic jewelry. Yeah, that's what you get in a junk drawer. Bunch of junk. And for the last Ziploc baggie, we have more coins. And I see Morgan silver dollar or heavily circulated. 90% silver, 1900. 9.75, 5 cents, 50 cents, steel penny, Buffalo, 1962, 9% silver, and Mercury dime, 1924. Wow, that was a lot of fun. I think we're done. 21 gold bucks. There you go. That's like $100 out here at least. Then we got out here so many Morgan silver dollars. Melt value of that stuff is like $20, piece dollar, same thing, $20, another Morgan, another piece. So $120 plus $35. By the way, I bought it on auction. I was trying to bid as low as possible. I did miss out on a lot of junk doors because people went crazy outbidding me on some of those junk doors. So yeah, super nice. Check this out. A whole pile of baseball cards. And a football and all this type of different cards. A whole pile of random coins over here too. I don't think those ones are super valuable. But I'll take it. And right here, whole collection of matches. I need to separate stuff, generic jewelry, and get rid of some of the stuff because that's actual junk. Like, this is just a dollar, but guess what? It's still a dollar. You can take it to the bank, they'll give you a different, better looking one. So yeah, pretty awesome.